Hey guys, Chandler here, back my channel, Alternate Journey, and today I am going to be reacting to an animated video of a double incision top surgery. So, for those who don't know, I am a man that just happens to be trans. Unfortunately, I was born inside the wrong body, so I was born female, and I am transitioning to be in the right body of being a male. I am almost 9 months on testosterone. I do plan to get top surgery soon, but unfortunately, because of the coronavirus, those plans have somewhat changed. My original plan was to go to Maryland and have surgery at Beverly Fisher sometime in September. But unfortunately, with this coronavirus, a lot of trans individuals actually have to change their plans because, unfortunately, top surgery is not known as an essential surgery. I mean, it is, but I'm not one to complain because I understand we have to save these medical equipment for people who is suffering from this virus. It's a pandemic, so it's like we all have to like just step back and realize like this is a pandemic, this is really important, we have to take care of this first before anyone can get things that they need to get done. So I will not die if I don't get top surgery. I mean, I will if top surgery wasn't like an option, then yes, suicide would been my number one option, but I know I am willing and able to transition sometime in my life and everything. So now my plan is to actually have surgery probably like January of 2021, unfortunately, so like a year from now. But I do plan to actually do a little more research and find a surgeon that is closer to home, because unfortunately Maryland is 6 hours away, and I called with my insurance, and unfortunately my insurance will not work with Beverly Fisher, so I would have to pay completely out of pocket. I've been doing research with my partner Sam, and we have found a place that does accept my insurance. We're just gonna do more research. So yeah, anyways, this video is by Dr. Scott Mosser, which is actually a real transgender top surgeon, I believe, in California. So yeah, he actually has a lot of videos, and the description says computer animated videos to describe the available FTM surgery procedures, so without subjecting yourself to the gore of live surgery videos. Which is perfect for me, because I'm not extremely good with blood. Like, I'm getting better, but, you know, I don't think I'm going to do fine with surgery. This video, the full length, will be linked in the description down below. I will also be linking Dr. Scott Mosser's YouTube channel down below, so you can check out other videos by him. And if that link doesn't work, I'm going to also put his icon in the end screen for you guys to subscribe to his channel. So yeah, let's just get started.
Dr. Scott Mosser, and I am a gender surgeon in San Francisco, California. I created this video to demonstrate how an FTM double incision surgery is performed and to clarify some things that, even with a live surgery video, might remain a bit confusing. The double incision surgery remains our most powerful tool for chest masculinization. The surgery allows us to obtain the tightest, flattest result and to completely customize the location of the nipple on the chest, but it does come with the trade-off of a considerable scar on either side of the chest, and also a decrease in nipple sensation from possibly being hypersensitive to having more of a normal chest skin level of sensation.
So actually, a lot of people actually had told me this. So if you want to know like what the estimated feeling of your nipples are going to be after top surgery, if your nipples are in fact going to be removed, because there's different top surgery results that you can get, feel right here of your chest. And that's like kind of like the same feeling that your nipple will hopefully have if it gains back feeling. Most cases, they start to gain back feeling after years of top surgery, though. So it's like, don't be paranoid when like 6 months of post-op goes by and you're like, I don't feel anything.
This surgery is most suitable for patients that have a degree of excess skin in the chest with some overhang of the chest tissue. This is what I would call an infra-breast angle of less than 90 degrees. And this surgery is most useful when the patients simply want the flattest, tightest result which is possible. Double incision surgery is, in a way, started before even the operating room procedure, meaning that chest markings are placed on the patient before anesthesia, and these are important to the execution of the surgery. These markings allow the surgeon to make an initial determination of incision placement and also trajectory, and to understand how the chest contour appears when the patient is in the upright standing position. Once the patient is under anesthesia, the markings are double-checked, and the areolas are marked with a 22mm areola sizer, which is the average diameter of a cis male areola.
So that's actually really good to know, because like some people actually don't need the areola resized. So like if you want, just measure your nipple and see if it needs to be resized. All right, if you are a candidate for keyhole surgery, there are two different types of actual keyholes. So basically, one, if you have the average size of a male nipple, then what they'll do is the keyhole surgery is where they cut a little half of the nipple like underneath, and then they'll take the tissue from that. And that's the only scar. But there's also a keyhole type surgery. So they cut off the average size of the nipple of a male, and then they cut off the rest of the nipple and maybe a little bit of some skin, depending on like the size of your nipple or whatever. And then that little like donut shaped nipple gets thrown away, and they take the tissue from that, and then they, you know, sew the nipple back on. So it's like they are taking some skin off and everything like that. So it's like, that's why some individuals who have like slightly a little bit larger size chest can get keyhole just with that, was resizing the nipple.
These areolas are then removed and stored temporarily to be later grafted onto the same sides of the chest.
Okay, so I like how in the video they like showed a scalpel. So when I went for my consultation with Beverly Fisher, she actually said it's like kind of like a cookie cutter. So like it depends on the surgeon actually. Most cases they will use like a cookie cutter to cut out your nipple because like one, to get that exact average size of a male nipple, but also to make sure it's completely circular. Now, of course, the nipple can be completely circular when they take it off, and it depends like how the surgeon sews it back on. But it's definitely better, definitely ask your surgeon if they use a cookie cutter method or if they just scalpel it out.
Sometimes liposuction is performed in the upper chest and the outer chest areas, and if necessary, it's performed at this step. Then the incisions are made, and care is taken to remove as much of the breast tissue as possible while providing a smooth and even contour of thickness of the fat beneath the skin, and extending into the upper, outer, and the surrounding chest areas. This is a component of surgery which is very important to get a smooth and even result and really requires a lot of attention to detail on the part of the surgeon. Then the skin edges are lined up meticulously to provide a smooth final result, and the skin edges are sutured closed with dissolving stitches that cannot be seen from the outside. At this point, the optimal location for the nipple and areola is determined based on the body's particular characteristics and also the shape and orientation of the underlying muscles. This is a procedure where some science and some artistic intuition on the part of the surgeon will come to play.
You do actually have a choice of where your nipples want to be placed. Like, you can tell them, like, where you think that you want them, or just actually just tell them, like, wherever you think would best be possible for me. Yeah, because they do determine like with the muscle within your body and everything like that, but you can just like ask them to do it as natural to your body or like what a standard cis man is. Also, I don't know if he's gonna mention this later, but you can actually suggest and like what your surgery scars want to look like. In this video, they do show a little bit curved. That is like kind of like the typical trans scars when you see. Most surgeons do it curve just so it can like perceive more masculine, looking like it has, you have some pecs going on. They try to match it as best as possible to when you do actually start working out, if you want to work out and gain some pecs. So when you do actually start to build the pecs muscles, the pec line is where the scar line would be. Unfortunately though, some surgeons mess it up just because like you either don't have some like muscle underneath and you're a scrawny little boy or whatever, and it's just like sometimes that happens. That's why personally for me, if I do get a double incision, I want straight lines because like it just looks neater to me, and like if the surgeon does mess up, it doesn't ruin the effect of the actual natural pecs or anything like that. So like that's why I want to do that. It just looks neater, cleaner. And like also to me, like when you first get surgery done and you have like a curved, it kind of looks like this tissue there. In my opinion, it doesn't look like a pec. It looks like there's some tissue and it still looks like an actual female chest. But that's just my own personal opinion. It looks different to everybody. Some people actually see it as like looking like a male pec.
Once the optimal location of the nipple and the areola is determined, the skin is marked here once again with a 22mm areola sizer, and the outermost skin is removed. The nipple grafts, which have been thinned and prepared for grafting, are then placed over these regions and secured in place with the stitches that will ultimately hold the outer bolster dressing in place. The additional sutures are placed outside the skin graft to secure it in place, and then the bolster dressing is applied. These funky-looking bolster dressings are necessary to hold the skin graft into place for the critical first few days of skin graft take after surgery. Most of my patients do not receive drains for a double incision procedure. When they are...
That's weird that he says most patients don't get it. Because, like, when I was talking to, like, Beverly Fisher, when I was planning to go to her, like, she said, like, most cases, like, yeah, you do have it for, like, 5 to 7 days. So that's weird, but it just depends on your chest size, also the surgeon, how they like to do things.
Some options in this procedure include joining the incision centrally if there is a lot of excess skin right in that region, which can help prevent any pleating or ruffling of the skin and instead have a flat, smooth contour if that is necessary.
Oh, see, I didn't know that was that for. I thought some people just like their scars connected. I didn't know there was an actual reason to get more skin that was there.
Additionally, excess skin and fat in the outer chest might be able to be removed by extending the incisions laterally if necessary.
Yeah, that is to prevent a dog ear effect. Also, like what he was talking about in the beginning with the liposuction, that is to also decrease the chances of getting dog ears, which if you do not know what dog ears are, it is basically excess skin on the side. This usually happens with like larger chested individuals. It just looks like kind of like dog ears. Some surgeons do not do the extended line thing right then and there. They usually wait until you recover from the main top surgery. And then if you want a revision, you can get that extended, inch or two to remove the dog ears. It depends on your surgeon, how much they actually want to do at that point, how much they want to put your body through.
So that's about it. Hopefully this has helped to explain a bit about what the time-honored double incision procedure is all about. It does have its trade-offs, but in many ways, it's still the most powerful tool that we have for many body types for chest masculinization surgery.
This is actually a really good video, and like I like this before and after. That's like basically the ideal before and after that every trans man wants. This video got me even more excited for surgery, like holy shit. That was really cool. I like how they actually showed like what the muscles look underneath, and the tissue was kind of really gross. But of course, this wasn't a live surgery. A live surgery, it would be extremely gross, and yeah. But yeah, anyways, I hope you guys found this video entertaining and like useful for you guys. Some people don't know what top surgery is or what the actual procedure is, like step by step. So this was very helpful for that. But yeah, just to remind you guys, you do have a choice of how your nipples are going to be placed, shaved, and your scars as well. This isn't just because this is the typical trans man or non-binary surgery. That does not mean that your chest has to look like this. It can look however you want it. So yeah, anyways, please like, comment, and subscribe if you are new to my channel. I make videos whenever I can, but you can always expect important updates on my transition. Alright, see you guys.